What is up, everybody? It's Animac here for Anime Uproar, and today I will be exploring the theory that Percival, the main protagonist of the Seven Deadly Sins sequel, Four Knights of the Apocalypse, is not a regular human. There is clearly something very unique about him, and there are a lot of missing pieces in terms of his mysterious origin story. What if Percival is a descendant of the ancient wizards of Belialuin? And beyond that, could Merlin be Percival's real mother? There is a lot to talk about here, so let's get into it. You guys know the drill. If you enjoy our Seven Deadly Sins and Four Knights of the Apocalypse videos and you want to see more in the future, just leave a quick like and comment. It only takes a second, but it helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm. And if you're new to Anime Uproar, or maybe you watch our videos but you just haven't taken the time to subscribe yet, do me a quick favor and make this the video that you subscribe and hit that notification bell to turn on all notifications. You can also hit me up on Twitter and Instagram at Anime Uproar. Finally, this video will contain spoilers for the Four Knights of the Apocalypse manga, so please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Okay, so for a long time it has been clear that Percival is not just an ordinary human. I mean, he appears to be some type of human. He's obviously not a giant, he doesn't have fairy wings, and so on. But there are multiple things about him that make him stand out from regular humans. Aside from the fact that he is seemingly destined to become one of the Four Knights of the Apocalypse, Percival is also freakishly strong in terms of physical strength, and he seems to have possessed this type of strength since birth. Even when he reverts back to a baby in chapter 38, Percival is still freakishly strong. He also has an incredibly overpowered magic, Hope Magic, a hero-type magic that only appears in 1 out of 10,000 people. But the more we learn about Hope Magic and how versatile it is, the more it seems like Percival's magic is a lot rarer than just 1 in 10,000. On top of the exceptional physical strength and rare overpowered magic, Percival can actually speak the language of the demons. And even Percival doesn't seem to have any idea why he can speak the language of the demon clan. This has caused a lot of speculation about Percival's true background and race. He seems to believe that he is just a normal human, but what if that's not the full story? I mean, he doesn't even seem to know who his mother is. As I was wondering about Percival's true origins, a patron of ours named Turner B suggested that Percival might be a descendant of the wizards or sages, that unique subgroup of humans who lived in the fallen city of Belialuin, the same city that Merlin is from. While they are technically classified as humans, they are also distinct. They are wizards and witches who possess immense magical knowledge and power. They lived separately from the other humans in Belialuin, the capital of the wizards. Belialuin remained neutral during the ancient Holy War, and the city was known for its prosperity and advanced magical knowledge. Merlin was of course born in this city, and her father was actually a powerful mage and the chief of the capital. Perhaps because of her genetic connection to such a powerful mage, Merlin was born with the power of infinity, a magic that eclipsed even the most powerful wizards and witches of Belialuin. This magic is so overpowered and so versatile that both the Demon King and the Supreme Deity attempted to get Merlin to switch over to their side during the Holy War. And in return for joining them, they offered her valuable gifts. However, Merlin tricked the Demon King and the Supreme Deity, and she took the gifts offered by both sides but didn't join either. The two gods were so angered by this trickery that they destroyed the entire city of Belialuin and killed everyone in it, allegedly. Ironically, the one person who was their primary target, Merlin, managed to escape the destruction, and she became the only known survivor from the capital of the wizards. This is all information that we learned pretty early on in the original Seven Deadly Sins story, but in the final arc of the manga, the King of Chaos arc, we got more details about Merlin's early life and the inner workings of Belialuin before its destruction. The fact that Belialuin was known for possessing such powerful magic was not a coincidence. As a society, they focused much of their energy on magical research, including experimenting on children who showed a high aptitude for magic, such as Merlin. Their goal was to turn these children into powerful weapons who could one day defend the city from even the strongest members of the demon and goddess clans. Obviously, this strategy ultimately failed since they got wrecked by the Demon King and the Supreme Deity. But even so, Merlin's early life was completely shaped by Belialuin's obsession with grooming ever more powerful mages. Because she was born with infinity, she was constantly forced to undergo tests and experiments, and she essentially lived as a prisoner in her own hometown. She also received no love or affection from her father, who was just as committed to experimenting on her as everyone else. Her life was so difficult that she eventually ran away from Belialwin, but the wizards pursued her and caught up to her. They were about to take her captive and force her to return to the city, but she was saved by none other than Meliodas. Meliodas was basically the first person to show any sort of kindness and affection to Merlin. He treated her like a real human being and not just some experiment. This eventually led Merlin to fall deeply in love with Meliodas, but he could never return her love because he loved Elizabeth. Merlin tried everything to win Meliodas over, including taking on an adult form, but nothing worked. To make things even more difficult for Merlin, she couldn't even be mad at Elizabeth because Elizabeth was such a nice person, and eventually Merlin came to see her as a big sister. Depressed because of her unrequited love, Merlin eventually returned to Belialwin, and she tried to distract herself from the heartbreak by immersing herself in magical research. She decided to absorb as much magical knowledge as possible, which eventually led to her gluttony for knowledge. One day, she overheard a conversation about chaos power, and this piqued her interest. She then made it her life's mission to revive chaos, in the hopes that this crazy goal would alleviate her heartbreak. Merlin continued to pursue this goal into the final arc of the Seven Deadly Sins story, and even now in the sequel, chaos power remains important. King Arthur is, of course, the King of Chaos, and for some reason he became a villain who wants to destroy all the non-humans in Britannia. Merlin seems to be standing at his side and supporting him, but it's likely that she's only supporting him because she is being compelled to for whatever reason. But the fact remains that at this point in the story, Merlin and Arthur are being portrayed as villains. So the story of Merlin and her pursuit of chaos power dates all the way back to before the ancient Holy War, and it continues to play an important role even now in the sequel. Merlin has been playing a significant part behind the scenes this entire time, and that is why I think she is going to end up being more important to Percival than we realize. It's important to note that in Arthurian legend, Percival is also raised in isolation from other humans until about the age of 15, which is similar to our Percival. But in most accounts of the legend, Percival is not raised by his grandfather, but rather by his mother. In some accounts, he's also the son of a noble knight, but that knight passed away at some point in the past, and his mother is currently a widow. This is fascinating because it really begs the question, who is Percival's mother? We know that Ironside is allegedly his father, although he certainly doesn't act like a father, but we know nothing at all about his mother. It's like she gave birth to Percival and then dropped off the face of the earth, which is pretty sus. Wouldn't Percival be just as interested in the identity of his mother as he is in the truth about his father? And yet all of the focus so far has been on Ironside. Oh, and the fact that Percival is able to speak the language of the demons is especially interesting to me. If Ironside really is his father, and if Ironside is just an ordinary human, then the ability to speak this language might be something Percival inherited from his mother. So does that mean that Percival's mother is a demon? I mean, potentially, but we know that the wizards of Belialwin also had knowledge of inhuman languages. For example, we know that Merlin's real name is unpronounceable to normal humans because it is in a language that they cannot even comprehend. So, could there be a connection between Merlin's real name and the language of the wizards and Percival's ability to speak the language of the demons? Although we've been told that Merlin was the only survivor of Belialwin, that information could be inaccurate. Someone else may have survived, perhaps someone from Belialwin who was out traveling at the time that the city was destroyed, and that person or persons may have had descendants. Percival, of course, could be one of those descendants. This would technically make him human, just not an ordinary human. The wizards and witches are more powerful than ordinary humans, they speak languages that ordinary humans cannot, and they possess magic that is beyond the grasp of regular people. All of these factors apply to Percival as well. We already know from the example of the giant clan that claims of a clan being wiped out or going extinct can be exaggerated. Despite the fact that Deanne and Matrona were supposed to be the only giants left in Britannia, the Cursed by Light movie introduced a whole bunch of new giants. Since I don't see any reason to consider the movie non-canon, we have to assume that there really are more giants out there, and the same could be true of the wizards and witches. Since Arthurian legend has some very interesting witch and wizard characters that we still haven't met in the story, such as for instance Morgan Le Fay, it would make sense to relate these characters to the ancient wizards and witches of Belialwin in some way. So there may be descendants of Belialwin out there somewhere, and Percival could be one of them. But if Percival is not the descendant of some other witch or wizard, could he be directly related to Merlin herself? We know that Ironside and his grandfather apparently betrayed King Arthur at some point in the past, even though Ironside still works for Arthur in the present. So, what was the nature of this betrayal? Could the betrayal be the fact that Percival was secretly taken from Camelot as a baby and hidden away from Arthur? And could the reason why Percival was hidden away be his secret lineage and maybe even his connection to Merlin? What if Merlin is the one who protected Percival from Arthur by telling Ironside and Percival's grandfather to smuggle him out of Camelot, which was a betrayal of King Arthur since it was done without his knowledge? What if Merlin did this because she knew that Percival was special in some way, maybe even that he was a descendant of Belialuin? And craziest of all, what if Merlin is Percival's mother? I mean, we know that Merlin was deeply in love with Meliodas, and Percival does look a lot like Meliodas. So imagine if Merlin used some crazy magic trickery to create an offspring of herself and Meliodas, and Percival is that offspring. She then decided to protect him from Arthur by sending him away to be raised on God's finger, and even now she is secretly protecting him by keeping an eye on Arthur. I know this is crazy and highly unlikely, but Merlin being Percival's mother, and even Meliodas potentially being his father in some way, would be such a mind-bending twist. And I mean, it would explain why Percival is so freakishly strong physically, why he has such incredibly rare magic, and why he can speak the demon language. I mean, again, I'm not saying that this is likely, but it sure would answer a lot of questions, and this sort of spicy romantic drama would kind of be in line with Arthurian legend. I mean, we all know about Guinevere and Lancelot, so you know, I'm just saying. All in all, the story of the sequel is getting extremely interesting now, so I definitely recommend getting caught up if you're not already. We are just over 40 chapters in as of the making of this video. Merlin and Arthur are already in the story, and they are currently being portrayed as villains. Gother also just returned to the story, and even Bonn or Lancelot may be in the story in the form of a talking fox named Sin. Sin's true identity has been a big mystery, and that mystery is only deepening as the story continues. Let me know what you guys think. Could Percival be a descendant of the wizards of Belialuin? That would still technically make him a human, but a special type of human. Could he be related to Merlin in some way? Could he even be her secret love child? Finally, is Merlin the one who had been secretly protecting Percival from Arthur and the Holy Knights? Don't forget to leave your thoughts down in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more in the future, just leave a quick like. It only takes a second, but it helps a lot. And if you want a completely free way to directly support the channel, consider subscribing and hitting that bell to turn on all notifications. It seems like a small thing, but it really does help us out a lot here on YouTube. You can also hit me up on Twitter and Instagram at AnimeUproar. Thanks again to Turner B for prompting the idea for this video. I will link his Twitter down in the description if you want to check it out and discuss Four Nights of the Apocalypse with him. I want to give a big thank you to all of our Anime Uproar patrons who make videos like this one possible. Special thank you to Alpha Sigma. This man is an absolute mad lad and a disciple of Lord Twigo himself. And I can't forget all of our The One tier patrons, the ones who stand above all other clans, including Ingrata, Algital, Pate Hefa, the Red-Haired Fox, Hinokami and Water, the Toasted Chi, Corey McGowan, the Spike, Dylan Isidore, Spidey Leftenel, Tungsten Tarkus, Baked Buddhist, Monkey D. Quilly, Cody Hebert, and Jeremy Cummings. Finally, thank you also to our Pro Hero tier patrons, including the one and only Gilgamesh, Steelers, Angel Cruz, Very Gucci, Alicia Octor, Bonnie Parks, Joanne Garcia, Fatboy Games, Kaido Might Be a Duck, Jessica Rabbit, and Jeremy Phillips. If you enjoy our videos and you feel that they provide value to you, consider supporting us on Patreon. Even a single dollar will give you access to our patron-exclusive Discord, and your name will appear in our videos along with these legendary people. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, see ya, space cowboys!